It is a castle dark and deep in the middle of the bustling European urban landscape. Welcome once more to Ghent and the World Gymnastics Championships on CBC. I'm Scott Russell. This is Gravenstein Castle. Once it was the fortress of Flemish counts whose warriors defended the land. They were a breed of specialists. And now, hundreds of years later, on our final day at the World Championships, warriors with different kinds of skills, but skills no less searing, will joust for gymnastics gold. For so long, the pride of tiny Bulgaria, Jordan Jovchev's strength is legendary. Now, can he strike gold? America's Sean Tauzin narrowly missed the all-around title, fell on his sword. His armor intact, it's time to shine. Ivana Vankoff loves the high wire act, team gold, individual silver. Still is sport's popular prince. The Queen of Hearts is Russian Svetlana Horkina. In some ways, there is no heir to her throne. Brazilian Danielle Hippolito is on the verge of a breakthrough and maybe a place on the medal podium. Romania walks the line and they've built a fortress with the balance beam, led by Andreea Radican. Today, the individual apparatus finals means the athletes sharpen their skills at the World Gymnastics Championships from Ghent, Belgium. The event finals are hugely popular to the devout followers of gymnastics. Hello again, everyone, and welcome to our coverage of the World Championships from Belgium. As always, Laurie Strong-Ballard is on side. And this time, Laurie, there are 10 gold medals at stake, and there's no reason for anybody to hold anything back right now.
The event finals are all about great, innovative gymnastics. Over the last decade, we've seen a change in the importance of the event finals. The new format allows countries to bring some of their event specialists who maybe only contribute on two or three events in the team competition, but almost guarantee them some sort of medal here in the finals. Specialists like Sylvester Cholani, the Olympic rings champion, and Erzika, who is incredible on the pommel horse, and from Latvia, Virov, who's so powerful on the floor exercise. On the women's side, Horkina and Radican could steal all of the gold, but they will see a challenge from a beam and bar specialist, Ezhova from Russia, and Chusovitna will go for her first vault world title.
One of the great things about this event is that it's wide open geographically. The event finals promises that maybe a different cast of characters could come into play.
You're right, Scott. It's not just about the powerhouse nations, China, Russia, and Romania. Countries like Latvia, Greece, Cuba, and even as small as Uzbekistan have a chance for a medal here. The bottom line is the parity is great. There are more countries involved, and there's a lot at stake.
Well, there are 10 gold medals at stake for sure in this one. We'll begin with the women on the vault. The men go to the floor exercise. The Flanders Sports Arena at capacity for all of the final competitions, 6,000 strong. The European fans now look towards the runway and the women's vault and towards the individual all-around gold medalist Svetlana Horkina, 22 years old, of Russia.
In the finals, the women must do two different vaults from totally different families. Horkina's doing the Yurchenko 1.5. Nice strong vault. You know, this is not traditionally her strength, but she still has a repertoire of vaults to choose from. Some athletes struggle just to get two. She has three or four different vaults. This is the Yurchenko 1.5 twist. Very well done.
9.35, her first score out of a start value of 9.7. Now the second vault. At the end of the day, the two scores are averaged for a total.
Okay, different family here. She does a half onto the horse and a 1.5 off. Amazing. Fighting for that landing.
Yes, completely different styles on the vault.
With her long, lanky body, the mechanics of this vault are so important. She gets a strong punch to do one rotation with a 1.5 twist off. Take a look here. She blocks very high in the air. That's 1.5 twist. Nice strong landing, a fight to the end.
Second vault, 9.475, 9.412, the average. And now we go to a young Romanian vaulter, 17 years old. This is Andreea Ulmianu, coached, of course, by the great Octavian Belu, tiny gymnast.
She'll do a similar vault to Horkina's first, but she adds an extra half twist. It's a double twist. Just drops from that horse into the landing. She is a smaller gymnast than Horkina. So her amplitude is smaller, but the judges have to take into consideration that she is tinier.
Start value was a 9-8, 9-2-8-7 for Ulmianu, the first score.
She needs to clean up this second vault. There were form breaks in the air on the first one. Totally different style. Without the round off, it's a pike half coming on forward. The technique of this vault is very interesting. She comes on a little too high, so she lacks the punch and rise off of the horse. But she is small enough to be able to get that full rotation with a half twist all the way around, a slight knee bend in the air.
Form breaks there. 8-9-5 second vault, 9-1-1-8 for Ulmianu of Romania. Now Iana Komskova, Czech Republic.
For years, she's been the star of this Czech team and is a great vaulter. A little bit taller, but so powerful. Very nice vault, solid landing. Notice she is opting to have no landing mat. That's up to the judgment of the coach and the athlete. Iana wants a little extra room for that landing because she is a taller gymnast.
Lists Svetlana Boginskaya as her role model and in many ways is reminiscent of Boginskaya's style. 9-2-3-7 is the first score. By the way, she just missed a medal at the World Cup final in Glasgow, Scotland last year. She was fourth in the vault final.
She's a strong vaulter. She could get a medal, but this right here could hurt slightly. A clean vault, but that is a lower start value, only a 9.6. She needs to have a start value of a 9.7 or 9.8 to be competitive with the rest of this field. Nice and clean in the air. I love her straight leg. Solid landing, but the start value is only a 9.6. And that's going to hurt her overall score. The two vaults are average.
9-1-7-5. She does get the maximum out of it. 9-2-0-6 leaves her in medal position. Andrea Raducan, 18 years old. And the Romanian star.
The pike half as well. The same problem that Iana has. It's going to be a low start value, only a 9.6. Sometimes these athletes qualify to the finals with a very strong vault. They only have to do one in the preliminaries, but it's a different story in the finals when you have to pull out another vault of a different style.
This is the silver medalist from the Olympic Games in this discipline. Vault one, 9-1-2-5. She's got some ground to make up here.
Now that's a difficult vault and very well done.
Romanian fans here at the Flanders Sports Arena love Andrea Raducan.
Half onto the horse, blocked so strong into a half back layout. You can see the new vaulting horse is really helping these women. The surface area is larger, it's much safer. We're getting some good vaults.
Much better second vault, 9-3-6-2. 9-2-4-3 puts her in second position. You talked about Oksana Chusovitina here of Uzbekistan, a mother, an older gymnast now qualified to the final.
She's made a recent comeback. Front pike with a full twist. Her first world championship were in 1991. So great to see her back on the scene and competing very successfully with these talented youngsters. A little step to the side, there will be a deduction. That is something new in the women's vault. They have that landing zone, and there'll be a 10th deduction for stepping over the sideline.
9-2-8-7 out of a 9-8, first score for Chusovitina, who is 24 years old.
She has to get a better landing here if she hopes to win a medal. The Sukahara with a 1.5 twist and a much better landing. She'll be happy with that one.
Tiny country of Uzbekistan, Oksana Chusovitina.
See why it's a different style of vault. She does half onto the horse, a 1.5 twist, keeps this one nice and square down the center of the mat. Very few landing deductions.
She's been through a lot with her longtime coach, Svetlana Kuznetsova. 9-3-4-9 for Chusovitina. So Horkina wins the gold, Chusovitina the silver, Andrea Raducan the bronze, just edging out Komskova of the Czech Republic. For Horkina, it's two gold medals at these Worlds, the other being individual all around, as the 22-year-old star continues to shine at center stage. into the Belgian fall, the patrons of countless cafes clinging to late afternoon rituals will return to Ghent and the World Championships in a moment. Romania is broadcasting from Ghent and getting some analysis from 1976 Olympic champion Nadia Comăneci, still the icon of this sport. The uneven bars, Laurie, and talk about swinging on a star.
And a lot has changed on this event since the days of Nadia. Big changes this year are the required element that starts and finishes on the low bar, and the element close to the bar like a free hip, stalder, or endo. These changes bring the low bar back into existence.
Here is Renske Endel of the Netherlands, and she'll get big support. A lot of Dutch fans in the arena.
And boy, the Netherlands have been outstanding. Once again, this brings us back to the parity of the sport. In recent history, the Netherlands haven't had the talent or the depth to be competing in a final, so now they're at the top. Beautiful stalder work in combination. There's a release move, a Jaeger. Her coach steps in just in case she misses.
It's exciting in here for the team final. The Dutch narrowly missed the medal, but the crowd was roaring throughout.
Very pretty form throughout this entire routine. Nice difficulty and a nailed landing. You can't ask for much more.
Yep, there are the Dutch fans all decked out in orange.
Beautiful endo work right there. There's a half pirouette into a stalder. Those are those in-bar elements that are close to the bar, a requirement. And another requirement, that's a release move, is called a Jaeger.
She's 18 years old. Renske Endel, the first up on the bars, 9.425, which is a great way to get it going. Sarah Morrow, a 17-year-old from Spain. She was born in Mexico. Jesus Carballo Garcia, her coach, takes away the beat board.
She has some wonderful twisting combinations here, gaining valuable bonus. She needs 1.2 in bonus. Every time she links one difficult element to the next, oh, hitting her foot on the Jaeger, a couple tenths deduction right there. But every time she links one difficult element to the next, she gains valuable bonus. The dismount, half in, half out, a little close to the bar. She stalled her rotation. We saw some form deductions in the hip heel. But other than that, the form was beautiful, hitting her pirouettes right on top of the bar. And take a look at her toe point, and her legs are glued together.
So the breaks make Sarah Morrow lose some ground here. 16-year-old gymnast Katie Heenan of the United States.
A little off to the side on that pirouette. Nice fight. These athletes train many hours a day. Beautiful Jaeger. And in that time, they do tremendous amount of numbers of these routines. It's important to learn to save some of the elements. If you're a little crooked on a pirouette, pull it back on top with minimum of deduction. Nice job so far. The dismount, double front, a tiny step.
Katie delivered an even 9 for the Americans in the team competition as they won the bronze medal.
Best Jaeger I've seen in the competition so far. Way above the bar, plenty of height to rotate her feet past the bar before catching. Just a very tiny glitch at the beginning, but she came back so strong throughout this routine. Nice tight body in her shoot over.
And betters her score. 9.212 puts Katie Heenan in second position. This is Tatiana Zaranova of Belarus, 21 years old.
Again, we're going to see a lot of pirouette work here. Full pirouette on top of the bar. To a 1.5. There's that Jaeger Salto again. In the last couple of years, we've seen the routine move more towards the pirouette work, but now with the new code of points, the judges are encouraging them to do big release moves. They want to see one or two, possibly three major release moves.
Coach Nikolai Liskovich steps in and then steps away once the release is done.
That was her second release move, a ginger. Looking good so far. There's a dismount. Oh, drops to one knee. 3/10 deduction right there. Big disappointment at the end because that was a solid routine. There's the full pirouette. Perfectly in handstand on top. She'll head down to the low bar. That is a requirement to have a connection from the high to the low and then also from the low to the high.
Zaranova was fifth in Sydney at the Olympics. 8.825 will leave her out of the medals here. Svetlana Horkina of Russia. Listen to this. Gold in Sydney, gold in Atlanta, gold at the 99 Worlds in Tianjin, gold in 97 at Lausanne, gold in Sabai in Japan in 1995. She owns this event.
She is beautiful on this event. Every element linked to the next. That's how bars should be performed. She has skills named after her on every event, including several on the bars. There's one right there. She's just so fluid. Pops that dismount way up and nails it once again.
Svetlana Horkina delivers again.
She makes this routine look so easy, and it is by far not. The difficulty level is so high, just like another routine in the gym. I love the dismount. Watch how she pops this way up. She'll tap her toes extremely high, way above the bar, finishing her second rotation and dropping into the landing.
It's enough. That's her coach, Boris Pilkin, in there with her 9.437. Svetlana Horkina wins gold on the bars at a fourth Worlds dating back to 1995. A popular silver for Endel of the Netherlands. Katie Heenan of USA takes the bronze. Svetlana Horkina now has three gold medals to her credit, four medals in all. She still has another chance on floor exercise. It is a city of history on the Lys Canal. We'll flow to the men's rings when we return to Belgium. The exterior of the Flanders Sports Arena, the next to last event for women, is the balance beam, a thin line between success and failure.
And on beam, the requirements are tough. There are six of them, plus they must gain 1.2 in bonus. The big change is the new required hold element, a scale, a planche, or a handstand adds diversity and originality to the routine, but also extra time to an already skill-packed routine.
Here is Russia's best beam worker, Ludmila Ezhova, 19 years old.
In finals, the judges want everything, the skills, the artistry. There's now a 3/10 deduction for lack of artistry. They're going to get it all with Ezhova, a beautiful first combination showing unique elements in combination. The artistry mark is a little hard to get on beam because one skill is connected to the next and they are packed full of difficulty. Not a whole lot of time for the dance. Take a look at this combination. A full twisting back handspring into an O'Millian check, which is a three-quarter twisting back handspring. Amazing, right on top. She's not done yet. Another unique skill, a handspring with a half. Half pirouette down low on the beam. There's her hold element. It must be held for at least 2 seconds.
Competing well for Russia at her first senior world championships.
The dismount, a 2.5 twist, hits the landing, a great routine. Just like I've seen her do every day in practice, in the preliminaries and the team competition. Just outstanding. The only problem is she's first up. It'll be tough to keep that score right there till the end.
9.65. Ezhova, the all-around champion from the University Games in China this year. Here is, from Romania, Sabina Kojocar, just 16 years old. European champion on the balance beam. She won that title in Paris this year.
Required tumbling pass. She takes it above and beyond, tumbles on the beam, a 4-inch wide beam like it's the floor. See the concentration? She has a big skill here. Front aerial, slight wobble there, held it together. Front aerial is one of those skills that has been upgraded. It's now a D-level skill, and she gets 1/10 of bonus, but because she wobbled on it there, she will not get that bonus. By Sunny, another D-level skill. You can hear her teammates cheering her on the side. Can't understand what they're saying, but it is illegal to coach her while she's on the vent, but you can give encouraging words throughout the routine. Here's a dismount, a triple full out of two back handsprings. All right, a couple tiny airs in there. But this tumble series right here was amazing. It's a full twist out of two back handsprings, just like it's the floor. It's an E-level skill.
Well, normally the Romanian's untouchable on the balance beam. 9.475 for Kojikar leaves her behind Ezhova, the Russian, who has a 9.65. Here's the 17-year-old American, Tasha Schwickert. Balance beam in the team competition where the Americans won bronze. Schwickert was 9.237.
Easy front pike. Gaining some bonus right there at the start. Tasha's routine is packed full of very difficult leaps and jumps where she gets all of her combination bonus. Front tuck, a slight wobble. She wanted to connect that to the tuck full. There's the Turgite half. Again, another slight wobble. Really can't afford many mistakes in an event finals.
No other events occurring simultaneously. All eyes focused on the balance beam. The crowd about 6,000.
And boy, is it kind of quiet in here. And sometimes that's worse on this event. You'd rather have the distraction of the noise. Or else you can actually hear yourself breathe, and that can be a worse distraction. Been upgraded to a C, to a back tuck kick open. Here's her hold element, has to be held for one and two. The whistle signals that she has 10 seconds to dismount. All right, a good routine.
The effort of Tasha Schwickert of the United States. The Americans have had a very good world championships.
Tasha chooses to do a fairly simple tumble series just to meet the requirement, especially when you compare it to Kojikar's full twist on the balance beam.
9.35 leaves Schwickert in third. Ezhova still leads with a 9.65. That could change here. Andreea Radican, the Romanian star, won the beam event at the World Cup final in Glasgow last year.
I can see a maturity in her. She's very poised and calm. Truly confident throughout this whole competition at World Championships. She also does a full twist like Savina. Nails it. That's an E-level skill, 2/10 of bonus, but actually the new code recognizes super E's, which are worth 3/10 of bonus. Very rare.
Very rare to see a Romanian stumble on the balance beam.
They are pretty incredible on this event. Their training is intense. They put in hours a day on the balance beam and numbers after numbers. It's really fun to watch them in practice. You see the whole Romanian team practicing one routine after the next, and there are very few mistakes. Nice combination. Switch to a one-arm back handspring back layout. She is solid. Little encouragement from her teammates heading into her dismount. Back handspring, back handspring sweep with double pike. A step on the landing, but a solid routine.
Here is Ludmila Ezhova, who has the lead at 9.65.
Take a look at that. Extremely difficult full twist. It's a back salto with a full twist. Remember, she's on a 4-inch wide beam. Pretty amazing.
Silver medalist from the last World Championships in Tianjin, China, Andrea Radican. Dismount there, straightens it up, and has the lead, 9.662. A Romanian in the lead again on the balance beam. Also noted to be great beam workers are the Chinese, Zhao Zhao Sun.
She's China's only female here, and how fitting is it that she qualified to beam finals on an event that China has dominated for years? Look at the precision in every single movement. From the dance to the tumbling. One arm back handspring, 2-foot layout, 2-foot. Very disciplined in all of her landings. An interesting jump there, a full twisting straddle jump out of a switch leap. Nice combination bonus.
Yes, you think of the great Chinese beam workers, Liu Xuan, Mo Hulan, so many over the years.
Front aerial, you saw how aggressively she pulled her arms up on top, wanted to connect it to that full twisting back handspring. Chinese do hours of dance training on this event, and you can see it in the precision, in their arms, and their legs. They also have a very interesting rhythm to their dance. Very enjoyable to watch. The switch ring leap. It's a requirement to do a leap of 180-degree split. Here we go with the dismount, a double back, one step, but just beautiful. But Radican was amazing as well, and Andrea does have the reputation. Certainly an advantage in a judged sport. The tumble series was nice, a little turn of the hips, but she was so disciplined on the landing.
9.575 for Sun, good enough for a medal. Very close competition, not much to choose between Andrea Radican of Romania and Ludmila Ezhova of Russia. The former wins by 1/100th. The 17-year-old Chinese gymnast Sun winds up with the bronze medal. Romanian superstar Andrea Radican, the runner-up no more, a gold medal on the traditional event for her country's gymnastics heritage, the beam. Well, straight lines, but there are bumps in the road coming up for the men. The parallel bars are next. We move to the marquee event for the women, the floor exercise, where choreography becomes a big part.
Absolutely. The judges want to see it all on this event. Big tumbling is a must, but now they require a turn with a minimum of a B value and two large leaps connected. And don't forget about that 3/10 for artistic value.
Tabitha Yim of the United States leads it off, just 16 years of age.
And she knows how to make full use of that 3/10 awarded for beauty, femininity, character, and entertainment value. To a front half. Normally she does a front pull right there. That won't be a deduction, but she won't get credit for the difficulty. There's her turn, minimum of a B. That's actually a D, so she gets a 10th of bonus if done clean. Tabitha is an amazing twister. Here we go with a triple full all the way around. She's actually trained quads in the gym.
Being a whole new generation of American gymnasts here. Gone are Dominique Dawes, Shannon Miller, Dominique Mucianu. Now the days of Tabitha Yim.
Last pass, a front double full, dancing right out of it. A beautiful routine.
Americans won the bronze medal in the team competition. They have a gold medal, Don Towson, in the parallel bars, great world championships.
My only criticism is this routine's a little heavy on the twisting side. The judges want to see a little bit more varied composition, maybe some double saltos thrown in there.
9187, the lead score now for Tabitha Yim of the United States. Here is a very explosive gymnast, Dan Santos, 18 years old of Brazil. Last world championship, she was 59th, has come a long way to get to the final.
She is doing a great job, and I really like her style. She's an incredible tumbler, very explosive leg. See with this opening pass, it's a double layout, just drops into the landing. And a double Arabian, a little stiff on that landing. This is where the routine gets fun. Pulling in the crowd, they're clapping along. Definitely seeing more jumps in the routines because of the new code. The gymnasts not only have to tumble big and put combinations together, they need to gain probably about 5/10 just in the leap and jump. Finishing with a double pike, drops into the landing. Wow, big jumps, big tumbling, nice style.
And their coach knows how to work the code. Oleg Ostapenko has come over from Ukraine to lead the Brazilian side.
And Scott, I think one or two more years with Ostapenko to polish things up, and we're going to see even better from Danielle. He has a lot of talent to work with.
9-3-2-5, still early in this final competition, moves her ahead of Tabitha Yim into first place. Here is someone to be reckoned with, Andreu Radican. Gold on the beam here at the World Championships and finished for Romania in the team competition on the floor exercise where they won the gold medal.
Opening with a full in back out. That is now a E-level skill. The triple full, showing a nice combination of double salto elements and twisting. We're seeing a more mature choice in her choreography and music for Andrea. Event finals are always interesting because we see such a wide range of character and style amongst the gymnasts. This is an important task right here. This is where she struggled in the all-around competition. And she's got it today, 2.5 to a front layout, and this smile tells it all. The ladies do 4 tumbling passes now. Incredible endurance. 1.5 minute routine, finishing with a double pike. Boy, a 10-0 start, and with these clean landings, that's going to be a tough routine to beat.
Diane Santos, all she can do is watch. And Raducan is the world champion from 99. Her coach, Octavian Ballou.
Here's that opening pass. It's a double salto with a full twist in the first rotation. A solid landing.
9-5-5. or Raducan trying to win back-to-back world championships. Svetlana Horkina trying for another gold medal.
Same opening pass as Raducan. Well done. Probably the best I've seen her do it throughout this entire competition. This is where she works at Scott. Pulls the crowd in with her eyes. Makes the judges feel her routine. Whip to a triple twist, not fully completed, small sidestep. Same routine that she performed in Sydney. It suits her so well. Last pass, only three of them for Horkina. A little stumble on the landing. A beautiful routine, but I'm not sure that it was as clean as Raducan.
With the routine in Sydney, she won a silver medal. There is Andrea Raducan, her 9.55 leads.
Andrea's landings were much better. Horkina struggled with the triple full, not completing it, and the sidestep.
With Tabitha Yim for a photo, 9.375, disappointed to be in second place. Another country becomes a part of the mix, Australia, and Alana Slater, 17 years old, from Perth.
What an amazing leotard she has on. It all adds to the presentation. Whip to a triple full, the same pass that we just saw Horkina do. Getting two tumbling passes out of the way right at the start. A nice cover up there, doing a layback out of that front layout.
The Australians have come such a long way under the direction of their head coach, Peggy Liddick. Liddick is an American, former coach of the world champion Shannon Miller.
And she had them in spectacular form before Sydney, but they had a disappointing result in the team competition. But we did see a glimpse of what they're capable of. Doing a great job with the presentation, almost very similar to a rhythmic routine. But of course, with the big tumbling, finishing with a double pike, a slight straddle of the leg. Great job for Alana.
Well, she is a player in the competition. Slater was sixth at the World Cup final in Glasgow last year.
She covered up this tumbling pass superbly. 2.5 to a front layout, almost under-rotated, did a kick with a layback.
Gets into the third spot, 9.337. Danielle Hippolito of Brazil with a chance and a medal.
A big double layout opening pass, beautiful.
Born in Sao Paulo, lives in Rio de Janeiro, just missed the bronze medal in the all-around competition.
Double Arabian, a little stiff on that landing, that can be dangerous for the knee. Powerful, dramatic style. Music changes here. lower front layout. She makes it look easy, and that's a tough combination.
Andrea Radokranz, 9.55, still leads. Hippolito is the last gymnast in the field.
The clean finish, a triple full. A clean routine. I think that's capable of a medal.
Is it capable of beating Radokranz?
Very explosive tumbling, nice difficulty. There's the 2.5 to a front layout, legs glued together.
Not quite enough. 9.487 will make her second. It is a big win for Romania. Octavian Balu and Andrea Radokranz. A second gold medal for her. She claims top prize for exercise narrowly over Hippolito of Brazil. Another medal for the dominant Svetlana Horkina of Russia. Andrea Radokranz failed in her attempt to win the all-around, but is harvesting respect here.
I don't find many words to explain how happy I am. It was very nice for me. It was a nice experience winning two gold medals of this women competition, and I'm happy.
We're on our way to the final event from the 2001 World Championships. The high bar is just ahead. Stay with us. Welcome back to Ghent. That is the Lys Canal, which runs through the heart of this magnificent Flemish city about 45 minutes from Brussels. The final event to the risk takers now and the high bar.
One thing's for certain, you can't have a fear of flying on this event. Notice the requirement of a flight element. Only one is required, but most do two, three, or more. Connected release moves and Kovacs, which are double saltos over the bar, are very popular.
First up, a 20-year-old from Ukraine, Andrei Lipsky. His coach, Igor Korobchinsky, won a gold medal for the CIS at the 92 Olympics.
There's a Kovacs with a full twist. They call it a Coleman. So difficult. And a tucked Kovacs right on. Judges are looking for pointed toes, straight legs, tremendous form into his L giant right there. A required grip change and an in-bar element. So far, so good. Hop 1.5. See him gaining speed right here. It's important for the dismount. Double twisting, double layout, a little short on rotation, forces him to take that hop.
Korobchinsky likes the routine of Lipsky.
Some pirouette work at the hop, 1.5 into his L grip. Very tough hand position.
9.525, first score on the horizontal bar. Alexander Boresh, another Ukrainian gymnast. This, by the way, is the event on which Alexander Jelkov of Canada won a silver medal at the last World Championships.
I'm sure he's in the audience watching these specialists here to see exactly what he needs to do for the next World Championships. There's the Coleman. Alexander is one to watch. He is a master on this event. And the tucked Kovacs, very popular release move because of its difficulty value. And the dismount, will he stick his landing? And he does. Outstanding job.
Not one step. Gives the crowd the pump. Bresh was fifth on the high bar at the Olympics. Korobchinsky's got congratulations for him.
See how he pulls down on the bar to give him ample height to do this double salto with a full twist.
Wow, big, big score. 9.725. Bresh far and away the leader. 24-year-old Igor Cassina of Meda, Italy. Maurizio Aliavi, the coach, helps him up.
Oh, he does a leg out Coleman, the same release move we saw Buresh do earlier, but he did it in the straight position and now again in the tuck position. A little bit sloppy though. And a tucked Kovacs, amazing. Three release moves, major release moves already in this routine. And there's his fourth. But each time he's done a release move, he has been deducted 1 to 2 tenths for his form. And that will hurt in the overall score. There we go, dismount. A double-double, tiny hop on the landing. Just a few tiny deductions on his form, but the difficulty was outstanding.
Has a long way to go to catch that 9.725 posted by Buresh.
Here we go with the layout, Coleman. Two saltos in the laid out position. He has to get extra height so that he doesn't clip his feet on that steel bar. Here's the tucked Kovacs. Would have liked to have seen a tighter tuck position on that element.
9.55 for Cassina. Will put him currently in the second spot. Philippe Rizzo of Australia.
An amazing opportunity for this gymnast. He was actually the alternate coming into this finals. But when Donghua Kim was out with the torn bicep in the team competition, it opened the door for Rizzo.
That is his coach, Vladimir Vyatkin, who is the former coach of Ivana Vankov of Belarus, now working in Australia.
This is every gymnast's dream, to have the opportunity to compete in a final, because once the door is open, anything can happen, and he's doing a great job there. That release move is called a death. Very clean routine, and he finishes strong, nails the landing. What an amazing job.
20 years old, Philippe Rizzo out of Canberra.
Talk about stepping up to the plate. The door was open, and he took full advantage of this opportunity, nailing his death.
9.725. Yes, the alternate is tied for the lead with Buresh. Vlasios Maras of Greece. He's only 18 years old.
And again, Greece is a country without depth, but they have a handful of superstar specialists. Oh, nice high release move there. We've seen so many Kovacs today. Nice to see something different. Scotty's doing a great job of being aggressive, but not getting ahead of himself. It's important that he doesn't get anxious and he finishes every element to its fullest. Paying attention to the details. Can he get the landing? That's important. And he nails it. Punctuates it right to the end.
18 years old is coach Dimitrios Raftos.
There's that amazing release move, double front with a half twist, adding variety to the routine.
9.737, the teenager does it on the high bar. Greece wins gold. Vlasios Maras, the last man up, first at the end of the day. Alexander Buresh and Philippe Rizzo of Australia tie for the silver medal. 18-year-old gold medalist, the only one from his country. Perhaps Maras is looking ahead to the Olympics in Athens. When we return, the final gymnastics perspective from the World Championships in Ghent, Belgium. Welcome back to Ghent, Belgium, and our coverage of the 35th World Gymnastics Championships on CBC Sports Saturday. Well, the individual apparatus finals are very popular, and why not? Because the results, Laurie, are not predictable, and that was borne out throughout the course of this competition at the Flanders Sports Arena.
Scott, this competition was incredible. It's everything that we love about sport. There were upsets, controversy, and most importantly, incredible, innovative gymnastics. The Code of Points sets the standards for gymnasts in this sport, but it's these specialists who continue to raise the bar with every competition.
Now, these world championships are over. There will not be another full world championship until 2003 in Anaheim, California. There will be a team event, individual all around, as well as the individual apparatus finals. But as you look back, Laurie, at Belgium, who was the shining star here?
Svetlana Horkina was a brilliant star. At 22 years old, she is still amazing, and I see every indication that we will see her in 2004. And why not? She's at the top of her sport. She's conquered the new code. Everything is sweet. And most of all, and most importantly, she is great for the sport of gymnastics.
There you have it. Lori Strong-Ballard on Svetlana Horkina. Great choice. Later tonight, Hockey Night in